Procrastination. You know you've been doing it. You've been doing it since you can remember. And now it's affecting you as an adult. It's affecting you in your finances. And it's affecting how you bring home the bacon and how you feed your family. So in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad, I'm going to share with you three ways to break and kill procrastination. Starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas, and still here in our office that we're still unpacking and squaring away and putting together in Carrollton, Texas, a suburb of Dallas. And before we get started, please click like and subscribe. And our goal is to make sure we get to 150,000 subs. So therefore, we can award a church charity or nonprofit organization $5,000 on behalf of you. Yes, the squad, so we can help them help other people. So please click subscribe. Okay, so let's get right into it. After 23 years of not only observing myself as an entrepreneur, specifically in the world of business, and also coaching and observing people in the field of business inside the insurance industry, I've noticed three major key areas of why people procrastinate. Number one, which is the fear of failure. Fear of failure means they're gonna do something, they're not gonna be good at it. They're gonna do something and they get rejection. They're gonna do something, they might lose money. They're gonna do something and listen, bottom line, you have to ask yourself as it relates to the fear of failure is what's the worst that can happen? What's the worst that can happen? What's the worst that can happen when you start budgeting your money? What's the worst that can happen when you start this entrepreneurial endeavor? What's the worst that can happen if you start volunteering? What's the worst thing that can happen if you start personally developing? What's the worst that can happen if you actually start gainfully improving on a day-to-day basis and commit to a lifestyle of change and improvement and constantly never getting satisfied with where you're at, but you're always cracking open new potential? What's the worst that can happen with all that? That's the thing that you have to ask yourself. What's the worst that can happen? The cousin to this is not only the fear of failure, but the cousin to this is really the fear of success. Like, I can't tell you how many times I've seen people say, you know what, I'm gonna feel so guilty. I'm gonna be making more money than everybody in my family. I feel like I'm gonna be pulled down and people will be asking me for money, or I'm gonna be one without the disability income or social security income. Like, their fear of success says I'm no longer be dependent on other things that I've been dependent on my entire life. And now that I'm independent, now that I'm free, now I'm standing on my own 2 feet, I'm afraid of that. You know, oftentimes I ask myself, why do people do that? And I remember a story when the Hebrews in the Bible were enslaved by the Egyptian people. And as soon as, you know, listen, I won't go into the whole entire story, but make a long story short, but Pharaoh let the Hebrew people go, let the people of Israel go, right? Because Moses kept saying, let my people go, let my people go. And make a long story short, he let his people go. And next thing you know, people are crossing the Red Sea, miracles are happening before their very eyes. And once they get over to the other side of the Red Sea, after the Egyptian army gets swallowed up in the Red Sea, the people of Israel, the Hebrew people said, you know what? It's tough now. I gotta fend for myself. I'd rather go back to slavery. I'd rather go back to this spot where people can controlling my time and controlling everything about my life. It was easier for me because I wasn't making any decisions. See, the fear of success means that you got to stand up for yourself now. And sometimes people don't want to face that because people are so used to being dependent upon somebody else. And now that everything that you've been praying for, everything that you've been hoping for, everything that you wish and dreamt about is now starting to happen, just crossing over this little hump. But the fear of success right there, wow, I'm actually going to experience this. This is actually going to start coming into my life. And sadly and weirdly and oddly, people are afraid of that. And so that's one of the things that keeps people in the same old, the same old funk, not ever changing their life. And the second part of this is a lot of people realize the work that's necessary to make your dreams come true. Man, I really got to invest 10, 15, 20 hours a week to learn a new craft. I got to really do some homework to really understand this lesson plan. I really have to do some self-study. And just FYI, guys, everything that you need to know to make $100,000 a year, $250,000 a year, $1 million a year, start your own business, cut hair, drop an engine, put another engine inside a car, tie a tie, everything is on the internet. Challenge now is, are you willing to do the work? No other era in American, United States human history has so much information been easily accessible to everybody online. We coach a lot of people, and on a monthly basis, I say, what's the difference between a person? It's in your same business, your same industry, relatively your same state, your same city. One's making $500 extra a month, another one's making $50,000 a month. What's the difference? The same industry, same license, same city, same state, same demographic. What's the difference? It's right here. They're unwilling to do the work because they know the work necessary to get things done. And by the way, if you unpack the things necessary for you to become successful, necessary for you actually get to throw work, it's not that difficult. If you really x-ray it, it's not a whole lot of work. It's just a lot of people just don't show up. A lot of people aren't willing to do that extra case study training and read that extra book and make that extra phone call. A lot of people aren't willing to do that, which leads me to number three. The reason why they don't do the work is because they don't have a clear deadline or goal. A clear deadline or goal. They don't know exactly what it is that they want. They're not very clear about what they want. And listen, there's a book out there that it's a Wall Street Journal best-selling book. It's written by my mentor, Your Next Five Moves. And his step number one, if you want to know your next five moves, step number one is clarity. If you're not clear about where you're going, what you're doing, what you're going to experience when you get there, then you're not going to move. It's not going to drive you to do anything if you're not clear. And oftentimes, if people aren't clear about their destination, the specifics of that destination, they're not going to move. Weird part about this too as well, if you're not clear about the pain that you're going to suffer from a situation of lack of action, then you're not going to move either too as well. You don't know what's going to cost you. You know, we're facing this new year right now. Ask yourself right now, we're what, 2 weeks into this thing? 2 weeks into the new year? Is this new year, the first 2 weeks of this new year, different than you operated the last 90 days of last year? If you're vibrating differently, if you're not working with a sense of urgency, you're not doubling down in your efforts, well, guess what? You're going to have the same year in 2022 that you did in 2021 if you're not operating in a different mode. You can't be the same person. You like, tell yourself, I refuse to be the same person I was last year coming into this year. So if you affirm with me, you are no longer going to be procrastinating, put it in the comment section below. I dare you, put it in the comment section below. I am no longer procrastinating. I am no longer procrastinating. So what I just shared with you is what people consciously do. The second portion is what people subconsciously do. They just do it by a knee-jerk reaction and you don't even realize that they're procrastinating. Here are three ways people procrastinate without even knowing it. Number one, perfectionism and having to overprepare. Perfectionism and having to overprepare. Listen, now, sometimes I see people's notes, meticulous notes, very clear notes. It looks so clean and clear. It looks like a textbook. People take notes, I need to know about this, I need to know about that, right? Let me ask yourself a question. When you're starting to ride a bike, how many hours of study did you take to read a book and watch video before you started riding a bike? You didn't. You just went with it. You just went with it. That's my point. So if you think that making more money in 2022 versus 2021 is that drastically different, heads up, it's not. The second way why people procrastinate subconsciously without even knowing it is worry and anxiety. Worry and anxiety. They worry about so many different things. They're anxious about so many different things. Listen, worry and anxiety about our things in the future that may not ever happen. Being anxious about things, oh, this is gonna happen, this is gonna happen, this is gonna happen. You never know until what? You do it. You never know until you experience it. You never know how you're going to operate riding the bike for the very first time until you start falling off to the left or to the right. Then you learn how to adjust. And guess what happens when you overcome that worry and anxiety? I'll explain here in a second. But when you overcome that worry and anxiety, this is causing people to not do the things they need to do to get to the next goal. And the third thing is they keep rescheduling appointments. For example, we had a guy that says, listen, man, if you're serious about your goals, you want to take your insurance test? Great. Set a deadline. Didn't set a deadline. A couple weeks went by. Did you take your test? No. Why? Didn't set a deadline. Why? There's no urgency. There's not really an area for him to say, okay, I'm going to get started studying day one, day two, take a practice exam day three. Another study, 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 practice day seven, study, study, practice, exactly, in that mode. There's no rhythm that he ever got into because he didn't set a deadline. So if you don't set a clear deadline to your goals, your dreams, some of the things that you want to accomplish in your finances, guess what? Subconsciously, you're going to start procrastinating. It wasn't until we got down and sat down with him that we put a deadline, we called the 800 number, we got the credit card to process the testing fee. Then did this person have a sense of urgency to taking their exam. Sorry, three ways to stop procrastinating, to eliminate becoming a citizen of this nation called procrastination. So number one, plan your day the night before. So there's a video here I want you to check out, which is the millionaire routine. Because you think millionaires have a daily routine. They get up, they start planning a to-do list, No, it's not. The millionaire routine, in my experience, is what you do the night before. So therefore, when you wake up, you're not thinking about your day, you're just doing your day. Number two, I started invoking this thing called delayed gratification. Delayed gratification. Listen, my wife and I made a lot of money in business. And I think the last 7 years. We made a little over $7.4 million the last 7 years. And here's the thing, how I invoked delayed gratification in my life to avoid procrastination. I grew up in the 80s when the Chicago Bears won a Super Bowl in 1985. Most dominant team in NFL history, the Chicago Bears, okay? And at the same time, too, a year before that, guess who got drafted? Michael Jordan of the Chicago Bulls. So a kid in growing up in the 80s and the 90s, there's not much Chicago sports around. And guess what? I didn't have any money to buy Jordans. I didn't have any money to even buy a starter jacket. I was broke. I had the same shoes my freshman year as I did my sophomore year, my junior year, my senior year. I had the same cleats my freshman year, same cleats I had my senior year. We were flat broke. I had nothing to show for. I was taking a bus. I didn't have a car growing up. I was taking a bus everywhere. I'd take a bike if I had the luxury of having a bike, but even if I chained it up, it ended up getting stolen. So I was 42 years old, in business, with kids, before I got my first pair of Jordans. In fact, my first pair of Jordans wasn't even something I bought. It was awarded to me as a reward and recognition for accomplishing a goal by my mentor. He awarded to me on stage in front of 1,500 people. And ever since then, I told myself, at that time, I think I was making $250,000, $300,000 a year. I said, okay, I'm going to set a little goal for myself called delayed gratification. If I hit a goal each month, I get a pair of Jordans. If I double that goal, I can get two pairs of Jordans. And make a long story short, in about 3 or 4 years, I became a sneakerhead. So I invoked this area called delayed gratification. I didn't put anything on my credit card. I have zero credit card debt. I don't have any personal loan debt. I wouldn't fund and finance designer clothes and things in my life on credit card, on debt. We moved into this office. They look at our finances. Boom, nice, clean, credit up. Why? Because we weren't spending a lot of money. We invoked delayed gratification, which is something that's very difficult to see in today's day and age because of Instagram, because of TikTok. Everybody's marketed to. And conversations like I'm having with you right now are considered boring and dry. But at the end of the day, it puts more money in your pocket. So what do you want? Do you want to look good and be broke? Or you want to invoke a little bit of delayed gratification? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years later, you're a little bit more financially independent. What do you want? Which leads me to number three. How can you get there? You can't get there by yourself. You need a accountability partner. You need somebody side by side with you in all aspects of your life. You need somebody next to you holding you accountable in your finances. Somebody holding you accountable in your physical life, your diet and exercise. Somebody accountable for you in your relationships, your marriage. Somebody accountable for you in your spiritual life. So many areas of your life and areas that you want to improve on and do well in, you will procrastinate if you don't have an accountability partner. Somebody that holds you to your word. Somebody that says, hey, you told me you wanted to do this. Didn't you want to do this? So how come you're eating that? How come you haven't worked out in 2 weeks? If you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, that person holds you to your word and reminds you of the promises you made to yourself to better your life and to impact the people around you, the people that you love and care about, so therefore you can be a better human being. Whatever that is, you need an accountability partner. So if you want those things in your life to improve, consider invoking these three things to avoid and stop procrastinating in your life forever. My final thoughts on this air procrastination is this. If you need somebody around you to motivate you, you've already lost the battle. If somebody has to constantly remind you of being disciplined and following through with your word, you don't really want it. If you're unwilling to do the work and put the actions behind it, you don't really want it. However, if you figure out what that is, now you're inspired. Now you have an internal flame. Now you have internal heat. Now you're vibrating and operating and you're expecting a greater outcome out of your life and out of every day. Why? Because you're internally inspired, not externally motivated. So what would you rather have in your life? If you're checking out videos just to get motivated, listen, I love motivation videos too. And we produce many of them, but it's not because we need to be externally motivated behind it. When we do motivation videos, it's because we're reminding ourselves that along the way, what a wonderful journey this has become. The only reason why you look back is to appreciate and be grateful for how far God has allowed you to come. So if you affirm with me that you're going to start removing external motivation and you're going to be inspired from within, put it in the comment section below. I am inspired from within. I am inspired from within. And one thing more, the worst word to use in our world, if you want to become a first generation cash flow millionaire, if you want to be the first person in your family to make six figures and $250,000, $500,000, first person in your family to be financially independent and free and debt free, is stop using this word tomorrow. Stop using the word tomorrow. I'll get it done tomorrow. Let's do it tomorrow. Listen, get it done today. Get it done now. Get it done right away. Stop using tomorrow in your language, and guess what starts happening in your life? You start getting things done immediately. So before I let you go, please check out this video here, how to become a millionaire in 10 simple steps. And also, speaking of mentorship and accountability partner, please check out this video here, a fireside chat between my mentor and I in Montana for Christmas, Patrick McDavid, the host of Valuetainment. Check out this video right here. That being said, guys, I'd love to know your thoughts, your comments, your questions, your feedback. You agree with me? You don't agree with me? Please put it in the comment section below. And if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow the business page, Money Smart Guy. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, hit subscribe and notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. That being said, from Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart, and be money smart today.